Hello and welcome to this video. Today I'll show you a cool library from someone else for the LEGO Mindstorms and by PrimeHub. The library was written by Vince 1911 and it's called Prime Powered Up. And maybe you own a LEGO Mindstorm sorter inventor and you bought it because you wanted to control it with a remote control, but then you realized that for the remote control feature, you have to connect the gamepad to the computer or to the smartphone, and then the smartphone or the computer via the streaming mode to the hub. The problem is that that introduces a few delays, so it would be better to connect the hub directly to a controller. And it doesn't work with normal controllers, with Bluetooth controllers, but it works with BLE controllers, or to be more precise, you can use this library to control the Spike Prime Hub or the Mindstorms Rotor Inventor Hub with a powered up remote. Normally, you should install this library as a library with additional tools, but I'll show you how to do it without any additional tools for a quick start. And I suggest that you use the Spike Prime software and not the Rotor Inventor software, because the Spike Prime software at this moment, or at the moment of recording this video, is a little bit more up to date. It includes a firmware update for the hubs. You can program the Robot Inventor Hub with the Spike Prime software as well. And with the firmware update, you can use Bluetooth Low Energy or the Bluetooth Low Energy commands that this library requires. And the second reason is that the Spike Prime software pre-compiles code that you write to the hub, so it runs faster and the delay between your inputs and the motions on the hub won't be so big. So let's start. This library has two interesting folders: the remote folder that contains the library and the examples folder that contains the examples. First, I will go to the remote folder, enter the control.py file, and copy everything from that file. Then we can create a new Python project. So we can create a new project, select Python. I will call it remote, as a remote. And then we can delete the stuff and paste the code that we copied here. I can make the text a bit bigger. So this is the library. But we want to have an additional code. This library only is for the code that works together with the remote. So it controls how the remote and the hub communicate. But we need code that does what you want with the library. So I will add a few new lines, and here we can enter the code that we want to use. I will use the example, so I will go back to the main folder, go to examples, go to driving, open the driving.py file, and copy the stuff from the driving.py file below the library. So now we have the library on top and the code for the remote on the bottom. You might lose the overview with this many lines of code, so you might want to install the library as a library in the future if you want to use the code more often. But for the purpose of this video and for quick tests, you can simply do what I did and paste the code below the library. And first we have to remove this line of code. We can simply put a hashtag symbol in front of it, because with this code you would import the library from another file and we have the code in the same file, so we don't need that. And now we can take a look at the code. The actual code that we execute starts here. We have interrupts and we have functions that get executed on the interrupts. So let's say that you connect to a remote, then the on remote on connect function will get executed. Let's say that we disconnect, then the onDisconnect function will get executed. And if you press a button, the onButton function will be executed. So we have the functions on top. We have the onConnect function, the onDisconnect function, and the most interesting function, the onButton function. This function is being called each time you press a button on the remote. And now we have cases for the different buttons or different button combinations. And this is basically the code that controls the motors. You can use this to control a device with two motors, or you can adjust the code to control something else. And I think that now I explained everything, so we can test the code.